Perfect love casts out all fear. I am the vine. You are the branches. Abide in me as I abide in you. These words from the first letter of John and the Gospel of John provide insight into who Jesus is, as understanding who Jesus is can be overcomplicated at times. In the early Christian church, fights broke out over Jesus' identity, over his humanity and divinity for hundreds of years. Councils were called, creeds were codified, people were excommunicated, and much worse. Even today, as we recite these creeds, as we live out the results of these councils in our particular denominations, the person of Jesus can be reduced to an intellectual exercise instead of a lived relationship. In John's Gospel, Jesus provides I am statements to help us better know who he is from a personal level. And they leave us much to ponder as we consider the identity of Jesus with our own identity as followers of Christ. And so in John's Gospel, we hear, I am the bread of life. I am the resurrection. I am the light of the world. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Last week, we heard Jesus say, I am the good shepherd. And this week, we hear another pastoral reference, I am the vine. And not only that, this is the only time in John's Gospel where there is a direct corresponding statement, I am the vine and you are the branches. Jesus explicitly names our identity as branches on this vine. And while I would much rather be compared to something that produces wine than wool, the reminder in both I am statements is our utter and complete dependence on Christ to protect, sustain, and nourish us every day, every moment of our lives. And in this example, the vine is God's love revealed in the person of Jesus, without whom we cannot survive or bear fruit. Because everything we do is in, through, and with Jesus. This I am statement takes us into different territory than that of the Good Shepherd. For as the vine, Jesus does not only protect us, but he is the source of any and all life, any flourishing, any growth that we experience. Vines are a long-term commitment for a vine grower because of the constant care needed for the vine to thrive. Jesus is God's long-term investment in humanity, in each of us. God, as the vine grower, must be intimately involved in the life of the vine, in all of the branches. And a vine connects the nutrients of the earth to the branches. And so in this image, Jesus becomes the conduit between the Creator and creation itself. And we are very much that creation. Vines grow around and up and through all sorts of places and spaces. Branches need to be tended to carefully. Dead parts need to be cut away, while the good producing parts need to be pruned, cut back, but not cut off, to produce even more fruit. And pruning puts our energy in a different direction. We may feel ourselves growing in one way or wanting to grow in a particular direction, and yet find ourselves pruned in a very different place, called to bear very different fruit than we had wanted, perhaps. And God removes what is no longer life-giving in us so that we may be free to return to that source of his love. And at times we may not realize that parts of us need pruning, or that there are elements in our lives that are keeping us from growth. And that experience of pruning may be shocking, upsetting, surprising. And frankly, that is how a lot of pruning has happened in my life. I think I'm going a certain direction, I'm super successful in this area, And then there's a pruning, a cutting back. And I find my energy directed somewhere unexpected, bearing fruit differently than where I had planned on my own. Pruning, then, is our ongoing conversion, our ongoing dynamic relationship with Jesus that calls us to love in ways that we cannot imagine. And even as parts of us are pruned, and even if we don't like it, we are never cut off from the source of God's unconditional love for each of us in the true vine. As we heard, Jesus invites us to abide in him as he abides in us, to be in relationship all the time with the vine, with Jesus, if we choose. Abide in me as I abide in you. Notice the mutuality, the promise to remain with us, just as Jesus invites us to remain intertwined with him in all the parts of our lives. We live this out in our baptismal covenant. We physically and spiritually experience this in our Eucharist each week as we pray for Jesus to be in us and for us to be in him. As he reminds us, just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. And apart from me, you can do nothing. That can be hard to hear. Apart from me, you can do nothing. We like to be so independent. Yet every good work, everything of value in our lives, our unique gifts and talents, the love we have and share, comes from the source of God's love, which is Jesus. He is the driving force of all that is good and whole and life-giving. It is only through him, through his indwelling within us, that we can bear fruit. In John's first letter, we heard that perfect love, God's self-sacrificing love revealed in Jesus, drives out all fear. Back in seminary, one of my professors suggested that the problem of humanity is not original sin, but fear. Fear of not having enough, fear of not being enough, fear that God's abundant love cannot be trusted, fear of the other taking what we think is ours. And this fear and all the permutations that result, anxiety, prejudice, injustice, selfishness, these fears are what need to be pruned from our branches, as they can keep us from the true vine, from bearing fruit and from flourishing. And so we are invited to keep returning to our source, to God's love incarnate, who is enough and makes us enough, because God's love for us is perfect. And God's perfect love, not anything else we can do on our own, casts out all fear. And fear is not of God. Years ago, a friend of mine who was much wiser than me remarked that everything in life comes down to love or fear. Every choice we make can be boiled down to those two things, love or fear. As Bishop Michael Curry says again and again, if it isn't about love, it isn't about God. And so we can use this as a tool to discern our actions, our choices, our decision to return to the source, that vine that is Christ. And consider, am I responding to a particular situation out of love or fear? How might fear be affecting my ability to bear fruit? What might need to be pruned within myself today and within our larger church community? Where is love driving our decisions, and where might fear be limiting our growth? Where might we need to be pruned and have our energies redirected? Where might we need to surrender to the true vine and let go of what is no longer bringing us life with God's help? Perfect love casts out all fear. I am the vine, you are the branches. Abide in me as I abide in you. Let us carry these words with us as we prepare to renew our baptismal covenants and welcome Charlotte Jane into the fellowship of Christ today. Amen.